Marijuana.
Blake Production.
Yo, what is poppin'? We're gonna do a quick little breakdown here, right? On Ethereum and Bitcoin. So I got this drawn up, right? Kind of like an inverse head and shoulders happening. That's what I'm thinking is happening in the background. It still needs a lot of development to see if this is gonna happen, right? Because we're like halfway through the pattern and there still needs to be a whole right shoulder being developed. For the most part, I see that we're in this falling wedge. And that's a bullish pattern, especially after we have a hard run all summer. September, we cool off in a nice A, B, C correction kind of pattern, right? But it's also kind of like a falling wedge into this $3,000 or $2,800 to $3,000 demand zone, right? As you can see, this was at one point a supply zone, right? We end up breaking up over and we're trying to use it as demand now. I like that. The wicks, like I like this a lot. This is telling me that there's still demand in this range. There's still demand in this range. So we could just be consolidating for a few weeks here just to get some cool off because that was bullish. Another thing, look at this sell-off, right? This was back in May. It was sharp. This was like 11 days, right? Right? Yeah. 11 days, just sharp pullback. This was fear, right? This is like, I'm still seeing some bullish sentiment in the market. Like, it looks good to me. I still think that it could be very well a good time to be buying ETH for like a next leg up if you're thinking of like a trade or whatever. But I like this for the rest of the crypto space. And I also, the reason why I keep up with ETH and Bitcoin so much is because there's stocks that like almost relate in price action, right, to Bitcoin and Ethereum. So all the miners and all these like stocks that like relate to crypto, you want to see how the main players in crypto are doing. So this is why I keep up on ETH and Bitcoin. So far I'm thinking we play in this falling wedge, and in the coming days, hopefully this week, we could get that breakout out of this wedge. And potentially in the bigger picture, we're creating like an inverse head and shoulders pattern. That's what I want to see in Ethereum. Now for Bitcoin, it's very similar, right? I was talking about that left shoulder, head, right shoulder. I want that to potentially occur in October. Like that's what's going to be like what we're going to be trying to see in October. But again, I'm starting to see a lot of this, like, right? We think of it as a 1A, B, C kind of pullback, right? Could think of a nice easy pullback because we had a whole summer of just going off. So this could be just a nice higher low in this pattern before we go for a nice run to end off the year. So don't sleep on this pattern, right? High, higher low, lower high, but it's a higher low than this one. Whew. We could be just coiling up for a nice big breakout on Bitcoin. I like what I'm seeing. So I'm keeping on my watch list. In terms of downside, it's just going to continue this right now. It looks like if it's going to go down, we have this A, B, C. This would, if it was this A, B, C kind of movement, then we're expecting it to do something like this where it will get that fake out, right? And then come back down here. That's the move that I'm thinking will happen if it is bearish. But I don't know. Right now, I'm leaning more bullish than I am bearish. It looks interesting. Remember, this is like the first pullback out of all summer, right? The first major pullback, and it was just 1 month. It looks a lot more structured than this pullback, right? This was fear, and it happened real quick, right? This was 9 days at the beginning of May, like, geez, or mid-May. So that's the breakdown for this week. Peace, guys.